Welcome to the student tour of Webcourses at UCF. Through Webcourses at UCF, you can access the information, activities, assignments, quizzes, and tests for your course. Log in to Webcourses at UCF using your NID and password. Each time you log in, you will arrive at the Webcourses at UCF dashboard. The dashboard shows a course card for each one of your courses. These cards can contain links to announcements, assignments, discussions, and files, depending on how the instructor has designed your course. You can change your dashboard view at the top right of the page to a list view which displays your course to-do items in an agenda view. Or you can select the recent activity view to display information about course assignments like announcements, quizzes, or discussions, as well as any inbox messages. To-do items, calendar events, recent feedback, and a view grades link are also located on the right side of the dashboard. To the left of the dashboard is the Webcourses at UCF Global Navigation menu bar. This menu appears on every page and provides quick access to frequently used Webcourses at UCF features. Click Account to set up or edit your notification settings and profile information. On the Notification Settings page, you can manage notification settings for all your Webcourses at UCF courses, or manage notification settings for individual courses using the Settings For drop-down menu. To edit your profile information, click on Settings. From here, you can edit your contact email preferences, change your profile picture, and change your profile settings. Next, let's look at the Courses menu option. Click the All Courses link to display all of your courses. If you want a specific course to always appear on your dashboard, or you would like to remove a course from your dashboard, check the Courses page. Clicking on the star to the left of the course name will place or remove that course from your dashboard. Select the Calendar option to display the important dates for all your courses. Every course has an individual selection option. Click on the colored square to the left of the course name to display the calendar events for that course. If you do not see an entry in your calendar, double-check to make sure the course has been selected. The inbox is an important communication feature. Click Inbox to access your conversations page. A list of your conversations will appear in the panel on the left side of the page. Notice the icon with the number next to your inbox. This example shows that you have two unread conversations waiting to be viewed. Conversations is the messaging tool used instead of email to communicate within Webcourses at UCF. You can send mail to your instructor and students in your course. Select the pencil icon at the top to compose a new message. Select the course the email pertains to. Then click on the person icon and select teacher or student, then select the individual person. The last item on the Global Webcourses at UCF menu is the Help option. Use the Help button to access Webcourses at UCF support and other helpful resources. Webcourses at UCF support provides assistance with technical issues, concerns, or questions related to online learning at UCF. Whether it's Webcourses at UCF, Panopto, Zoom, personalized adaptive learning, or test proctoring, we provide the help you need. Now let's see what a course in Webcourses at UCF might look like. Some of the basic course tools will be highlighted as we go. This sample course is an example of a typical online course at UCF. Keep in mind that other courses may not look like this one. Each course is built or customized by the instructor who teaches it. This is a sample course homepage. The instructor will typically put information here to help you get started. The sidebar on the right side of the homepage contains information about the course activities that you need to act on, as well as any recent feedback you may have received from your instructors. The course navigation menu is on the left side of the homepage. Use these links to navigate to specific locations in this course. The options which appear on this menu and their order may differ from each of your courses. Your course instructor will determine which options will be available to you. To open and close the course navigation menu on a particular page, click the Show and Hide Course menu icon represented by these three horizontal lines. Now let's review the most commonly used course navigation menu options. The Announcements page will list any announcements from your instructor to the students in the course. Many instructors will send out weekly announcements during the semester, which can be viewed here. The course syllabus is where you should look to find out what your instructor expects of you in your course. Look in your syllabus first before contacting the instructor with questions about course policies. Next, we will look at modules. Many instructors organize their course using modules. The course modules page is where you can find a list of all the modules your instructor has included in your course. Instructors can organize modules in several ways, including by week, chapters, or sections. Some instructors will make all their content available at the beginning of the course, and others may release it on a schedule as your course progresses. Notice that this instructor has indicated where you should begin in this course by creating a Start Here module. The Assignments page is where you will go to see activities that your instructor has designed for your online course. Like course modules, assignments may be all visible at the start of your course, or your instructor may release them on a predetermined schedule. Your upcoming and past assignments will be grouped and listed here by type or due date. Graded assignments for course credit will have their point value listed. As your instructor grades your assignments, this view will be updated to show your scores. The Discussions page is where you will find all the discussion topics for your course. These discussion topics are initiated by your instructor and/or your fellow classmates. Discussion posts can be either graded or ungraded. Any graded discussions will also appear in your assignments page. The Discussions page lists the discussion topics in your course using three categories: pinned discussions, discussions, and closed for comments. Click the title of the discussion topic to open the thread and view any responses. Now let's take a look at your quizzes page. Quizzes will be listed on this page by order of date due. You can navigate to a quiz by clicking its name in the list. Visit the Grades page to see how you are doing in your course. The Grades page is where you will find your scores for all graded course assignments, discussions, and quizzes. By default, these are listed by date with the earliest assignments first. Your score for a particular item will be shown along with the maximum points possible. Your instructor may elect to disable your total score. You can also see comments from your instructor here. The item title links to a page where you will be able to view the details of your submission. You can see the list of your grades to display additional details such as the assignment statistics and instructor comments. Dialogue between yourself and your instructor regarding this assignment appears along with your score in the detailed view. That concludes our tour of web courses at UCF. Knowledge of these course tools is a key to your success. Charge on, and I'll see you online.